Today I'll talk about citrus irrigation management. Water supply. Water is a limiting factor in Florida citrus production during the majority of the year because of the low water holding capacity of our sandy soils and the non-uniform distribution of rainfall. In Florida, the major portion of rainfall occurs from June through September, but rainfall is usually scarce from the months of February to May. This period coincides with the critical stages of leaf expansion, bloom, fruit set, and fruit enlargement, and additional irrigation is necessary to reduce the negative effects of water stress. Adequate irrigation management is key to optimize water use and increase crop yield. Several weather, soil, and plant-based methods are available for irrigation management. The most used methods rely on weather stations to calculate evapotranspiration, or ET, which is the combination of water loss by plant transpiration and removal of water from soils and wet surfaces by evaporation. Therefore, evapotranspiration plays a critical role in agricultural irrigation management. Allowable soil water depletion. As soil dries out, water becomes increasingly difficult for trees to remove, which can eventually cause water stress. Tree health and yield will suffer if the soil is allowed to get too dry. To provide adequate water for flowering, fruit set, and vegetative growth, maximum soil water depletion should not exceed 25 to 33% of available water from February to June. Once the rainy season starts, the maximum depletion can be increased to 50 to 66% of available water. This additional allowable depletion increases the capacity of the soil to hold rainfall without leaching nutrients or any applied chemicals. The same depletion in the fall and winter months will save water without reduction in yield. Irrigation scheduling. Irrigation strategies must be documented and practiced to allow growers maintain or increase crop production without depletion of our water resources. Increase in water use efficiency is achieved by selecting a proper irrigation scheduling method and application timing. Proper irrigation scheduling applies an appropriate volume of water to a citrus grove at the appropriate time based on tree need, soil properties, and weather conditions. Successful irrigation management maintains sufficient water and nutrients in the rhizome to maximize plant growth and health. Growers who focus on improving water and nutrient use efficiency simultaneously will reduce nutrient losses and decrease environmental impacts. While some nutrient losses are unavoidable due to excess rainfall, loss due to management decisions can be minimized. Current University of Florida citrus irrigation recommendations estimate citrus tree water requirements for mature trees using data collected prior to introduction of Wanglong Bing HLB, or also called citrus greening, into Florida. Citrus trees affected by HLB are known to lose substantial foliage and up to 80% of root mass, depending on disease severity, thus negatively impacting the ability of HLB-affected trees in water and nutrient uptake. The commonly used methods of irrigation management include soil moisture measurements, water budgeting, and smartphone apps. Soil moisture measurement. Experience or the calendar method can provide a reasonably good irrigation schedule, but are not accurate enough to maximize water use efficiency and prevent nutrient leaching. Using soil moisture sensors improves accuracy because they quantitatively measure changes in soil water status. These devices may be fixed in one location, portable or handheld. They may measure soil moisture at one depth or at multiple depths. General categories include time domain reflectometry, or called TDR probes, capacitance probes, and these sensors can help us determine how much water to use. Considerations when using soil moisture sensors to schedule irrigation include knowing the soil water holding capacity and tree root zone depth, placing sensors where the majority of roots are located, typically in the top 12 inches, such as at the drip line of the tree. Use multiple sensors, both across the grove and within depth, to fully characterize the tree root zone. Moving sensors to follow root growth as the tree canopy expands in developing groves. Base irrigation on the soil depth containing the greatest root density. Manage root zone soil moisture between field capacity and the maximum allowable water depletion, 1/4 to 2/3 depletion, depending on time of the year. Water budgeting. An alternative method to schedule irrigation uses a computer program that estimates tree water consumption. or evapotranspiration, or ET, from weather data. Reference ET and convenient irrigation scheduling management tools for all Florida citrus production regions can be found on the Florida Automated Weather Network, abbreviated FAWN, phone. The website is phone.ifas.fl.edu. Smartphone apps. Mobile smart devices, e.g. smartphones, tablets, have become popular because of their convenience and ease of use make them ideal for disseminating information on a regular basis with real-time data. Tools developed for use on mobile smart devices are typically called apps and are available for a variety of functions. EFIFAS has also developed smartphone apps for crop irrigation scheduling using phone weather data. The goal is to provide users with an easy-to-use mobile app to access information that will improve irrigation scheduling for a wide range of crops, including citrus. By using the app instead of a set time-based schedule for irrigation, more accurate irrigation is provided. Using the apps to modify the irrigation schedule has potential of reducing water and fertilizer use, resulting in reduced irrigation and fertilizer costs, and the potential of further reducing nutrient leaching. Irrigation strategies to improve nutrient uptake and reduce leaching. Developing an irrigation strategy to reduce nutrient leaching has the objective of not applying more irrigation water than the root zone can hold. Considering the low water holding capacity of citrus growth soils, this objective is very difficult to accomplish even for the most experienced and diligent irrigation managers. The major questions to be answered in this procedure are: how much water can the root zone hold? What is the maximum irrigation system run time before leaching occurs? Irrigation management considerations for HLB-affected trees. With citrus greening, or HLB, irrigation scheduling is becoming more important than ever as water stress will inhibit tree growth and crop production. Canopy size is reduced, as is the number of fruit and fruit size, and premature fruit drop will occur. In addition, extension growth of shoots and roots and leaf expansion are negatively impacted. Other benefits of proper irrigation scheduling include reduced loss of nutrients from leaching due to excess water applications and reduced pollution of groundwater or surface waters. The relationship between leaf area and water uptake indicated that diseased trees with lower canopy density and corresponding lower leaf area index take up less water and consequently less nutrients from the soil. Dairy irrigation increases tree water uptake and soil water content compared with infrequent irrigation schedules, irrigating every 1.5 and 2 days. For HLB-affected trees, irrigation frequency needs to be increased and amounts of irrigation water decreased to minimize water stress from drought or excess water, while ensuring optimal water availability in the root zone at all times. It is recommended that growers maintain soil moisture in the root zone, top 3 feet for each and 18 inches for flatwood soils, using soil moisture sensors or irrigation apps. The phone and the smart irrigation app provides the option of dairy irrigation schedules. HLB-affected trees with lower canopies use less water than do healthy trees. Therefore, if the irrigation scheduling app is used, the irrigation time should be reduced by 10 to 20%. For example, if the app suggests an irrigation time of 1 hour, this time could be reduced by 6 to 12 minutes for HLB-affected trees.